Hi, welcome to Eretec Solutions. This is Sheshanan. Today we are going to explain about automatic room light control using microcontroller application. So you can continue watching these videos on YouTube channel, which is Eretec Solutions. Please subscribe us. Application which allows to control your room light or any electrical load, you can control automatically by using infrared sensor. So I'll show you this application block diagram. So this block diagram will clear you like what blocks application contains. There is one power supply unit and infrared sensor module, microcontroller unit and liquid crystal display, relay unit and electrical load. The purpose of each block is very clear: per power supply, which allows to convert your AC source into DC supply. So the sections involved in this power supply unit as bridge rectifier, filter and regulators. Bridge rectifier converts your AC to pulsating DC, but this is not pure DC, it's a pulsating DC. This pulsating DC contains some ripples which are filtered through this capacitor, electrolytic capacitors. As the basic property of capacitor allows AC and blocks DC. The block DC which is given to this regulator section, regulators gives constant output irrespective of any input. The devices we are using in this application needs DC source with constant 5 volts DC supply. So mostly you are using 7805 regulators to get your 5 volts constant output. The 5 volts DC source you are using to all these individual modules. Whereas infrared sensor module, which is used to sense the object or persons who are entering into the room. So this module will work with very small frequency within kilohertz. So whenever person passes in front of this sensor, it generates one high to low pulse. This digital pulse you are giving to microcontroller as input. The LCD screen uses it to display the text, the status of application, what's happening with this electronic system. So most of the electronic system contains one display unit, maybe LCD screens or LEDs or 7 segments. That is a different choice. But you should give one display connection compulsory for your device. And the relay, which is electromagnetic switch. So this DC relay, here I am taking DC relay to take the pulse from microcontroller and it allows to drive your electrical load. The connections with this all these individual modules given in circuit diagram. So please watch this circuit diagram. So whereas infrared sensor, which is available as module, even you can take photodiode and IR transmitter also. So this contains 3 pins, VCC, ground and output. So you have to provide your proper hardware connections, whereas VCC required positive supply and ground need ground, and output pin you can connect with microcontroller IO pin. Whereas let's see this LCD hardware connections. LCD contains generally 16 pins irrespective of size. Whereas 1, 2, 3. First pin is ground and second pin is power supply, which is positive supply. You have to provide 5 volts again. And third pin is a contrast. 4, 5, 6. These three are 3 control pins from your LCD. So these 3 control pins you have to manage with programming. The first control pin RS used to decide whether you are sending commands or text through these data lines. So what is the need of commands for your LCD screens? So commands are always needs for your LCD screens for different operations. So anyway, this is liquid crystal display. As a programmer, you need to fix the position or cursor movement right to left or left to right, or scrolling operations, or whether you want to get the text from first line, first position or second line, corner position, all these things you can decide with some standard commands list. LCD follows some standard commands list. Before proceeding LCD programming, you should know about this LCD commands also. Again, all commands are 1 byte size. If you are trying to send command to LCD, manage this RS control pin logic as 0. Whenever you are sending text to LCD screen through the same data lines, you can make it RS control pin logic is 1. So this RS control pin logic decides whether you are sending command or text. The second control pin RW, which decides whether you are doing read operation with LCD or write operation with LCD. And enable pin. So for every change of data, you have to make sure enable pin high to low once. Even you are changing command, you are sending next command to LCD or next character to LCD, make sure enable pin high to low with some time delay. And this entire data lines D0, D1, D2, 8 parallel data lines, I just connected with complete port of microcontroller, which is port 3. And 3 control pins RS, RW enable given to 2.0, 2.1, 2.2. So these hardware connections you need to remember to develop your source code. Whereas relay. So this relay, which contains one internal copper coil, based on operating voltage of this relay coil, you have to give power supply 5 volts or 12 volts or 24 volts. The other end of your coil, you can program with microcontroller. If you are giving logic 0, then this common pin conducts with your normally open pin. So this pin is normally closed and this pin is normally open. Whenever this coil energizes, this conduction will come to this normally open pin. So coming to your load and source connection, the source one end directly given to load, the source other end you are giving to common pin. In the initial status, this is open. Whenever you are energizing this copper coil, it just conducts with NO pin. So this is how you have to give your hardware connection with relay and IR sensor module and LCD screen. So let's see the source code of this circuit. So the source code, which is already developed in Keil Microvision IDE. This IDE supports to develop embedded C programs for all microcontrollers. Whereas using this Keil Microvision, you can develop programs for all different manufacturers. So not only Atmel, you can develop different microcontrollers programs. So as IDE, it supports compilers, assemblers, debuggers, interpreters, all the elements which are required to develop your final executable file, which is .hex file for embedded C programs. Okay, so those steps you can follow from previous video, getting started with Keil. But this is already developed programming for this application. I'll explain line by line. The first line hash include RGG51.h, which supports to use all SFR register names you can use directly from the microcontroller. SFRs mean special function registers. Each feature contains list of SFRs. If you are aware of these SFRs, then only you can start programming microcontroller features. Otherwise, if you don't have any idea about SFR registers, no chance to develop source code for your microcontroller features. The three control pin connections I'm just defining with this S-bit data type. The S-bit, which is single bit from SFR register. Any SFR register you are trying to access individual bits, you can use this S-bit data type. But SFR should be bit addressable. The three hardware connections I just given across P2.0, 2.1, 2.2. See, I am not declaring LCD data lines because I am using entire port. Port name I am directly using in program. The two IR sensor connection, which is connected with P1.0 as per circuit, and relay connected with P2.3. So I am taking some user defined functions: LCD initialization, LCD display, LCD DAT, LCD command, and delay. So these are some user defined functions I am taking to deal with my LCD screen. Main logic starts from here. The first function I am calling in this LCD init. Let's see the definition of this LCD init function. See here, I am taking LCD command again with argument type. So I am passing some command values to LCD through this LCD command function. So you should know about this description of this LCD commands. 0x38 command value for activating two rows of crystals from your LCD screen, and 0x10, this is for shifting your cursor position to right, and 0x06 for make sure your cursor position right, and 0x0c display on cursor off, and 0x80 first line first position. So this LCD command function is already defined top of the program. Let's see this LCD command function definition. Whatever the argument you are passing from this initialization function, which is given to temporary variable val, this val is given to port 3 because the data lines connected across port 3 from hardware. While passing this command, make sure RS control pin logic 0 because it is a command, and RW logic is 0 because you are doing write operation, and make sure enable pin high and delay and enable pin low. And again, let's see the definition of delay function. So I am taking self for loop by declaring one temporary variable v. This is self for loop also helps to generate some time delay. So like this, I am executing all these commands one by one. Come back to the main program. After LCD initialization, let's see this function LCD display. So LCD dis function, again it contains automatic room, which is defined as string pointer. So this complete string which is saved in S. Come to the definition of this string function LCD dis. So the automatic room, that string which is saved with this S. Within this function, again I am taking a temporary variable w. So I am taking one for loop to pass these characters one by one. So let's see this for loop. Initialization start index start with 0, and I am comparing this string termination with null character. Whenever your string reaches null character, then you can turn it, the execution terminates this for loop. For the first character, LCD DAT of S of W, which means, so it passes the first character from your string as argument to this LCD DAT function. So whatever the first character you are passing here, which is given to this temporary variable and which is given to port 3. But while passing text, make sure your RS logic is 1 and RW logic is 0, enable pin high to low. So this executes until your string terminates with null character. Then the second line, so as 16 cross 2 or 32 cross 2 I am taking here, so it supports to use two lines. You can fill this remaining text. LCD command, which is C0, then only the cursor moves to second line. If you are not passing this command, your cursor doesn't go directly to the second line. So second line text, what I am expecting? The remaining text of my application title, light control using IR. Now I am entering into this infinite loop, which is while of 1. I am checking IR logic. So whenever IR state is 1, which means the object or person sensor through this IR sensor, whenever it generates, it detects, it generates high pulse. So that I am checking my logic with 1. Whenever IR sensor is detected, then LCD command 0x01, which means clear the complete screen, whatever you have on previous message, and display should be sensor detected on screen. And the second line, the cursor moves to second line, and display, which is light on. I'm changing my relay logic to 0. So this relay should be on until the person detects. IR is equal to 1 here. Wait until IR logic remains 1. Suppose if sensor is not detected, then the compilation will go to this else part. Clear the screen. No sensor detected. Light off. And relay logic remains 1. So these two things which is keep on checking by the microcontroller. Let's see this application output with simulation tool, which is Proteus. So Proteus simulation tool supposed to use to check all hardware results with the help of software. So there are many libraries which are supported by this Proteus, and this Proteus simulation tool you can use for all microcontroller families. But you need to generate .hex file from Keil Microvision. You can link your .hex file with this Proteus simulation tool and you can play your application. See the text, whatever I written on my source code, which is displaying. I just modified the code as using completely. So the same text you are expecting on this. So now the compilation enters into this while loop. No sensor detected, light off. So whenever this is my test pin, if I am changing my logic to 1 from this IR sensor because it is a simulation. Now this logic is changed state to 1, sensor detected, light on. So you can watch this hardware response from relay, and this is conducted with your NVO pin. If you change your logic to 0, then again no sensor detected and light goes off, and this will go to your normal position. This is how you can design your own application for your home or office. Whenever a person passes through this sensor, you can turn on your lights, fans, all these applications you can develop by using this simple logic. For more videos, please subscribe our channel from YouTube, which is Heretic Solutions. Please give your valuable feedback as comment and like and share. For any training related things, you can get back with this number 9676327118. Training, placement, development and projects, any related activities from embedded domain, you can get back with this number. And we are located at Housing Board near Metro Station, Kukatpally, Hyderabad, 5072. If any queries, please get back or reach us. You can write your email for ysnanda@heretechsolutions.com. Thanks for watching.